Want to elevate your e-learning projects with multimedia, but not really sure how to go about it intentionally or effectively? Or maybe you just don't feel like spending forever learning some new video production software. If so, you're going to love what Vyond can do. In this video, we'll explore Vyond, how you can use it to elevate your e-learning, and I'll even share some examples that might inspire your next project. Hi, I'm Kristin. I'm brand new to the team, so this is the first time you're seeing me here on the channel. I was working over at AWS, and now I'm really excited to be here on Devlin's team working as an instructional designer and bootcamp pro. I've been using Vyond in my e-learning projects for a little over 3 years now, and I've seen how it can completely transform e-learning from boring, information-heavy courses into immersive, story-driven experiences. I know you might be thinking, ugh, another tool to learn. While there are a lot of tools out there, this one's gaining popularity, and it's one of our most requested topics for video content, so it's one we recommend being familiar with. So what is Vyond exactly? Vyond is a video creation tool that's entirely cloud-based. So whether you have a Mac or PC, you'll be able to jump right into creating animated videos for your e-learning projects. It's subscription-based and it's easy to use because it doesn't require advanced animation skills. So although Vyond isn't as advanced as something like Adobe After Effects, it also doesn't require the same level of technical skills. So it's fairly quick and easy to use because of that. Vyond Studio, which is Vyond's video editing interface, has easy access to pre-made and customizable templates, and it also has a large asset library full of things like props, scenes, characters, motion, charts, and audio. Its features like camera movements, character expressions and actions, and emotions really help provide visual cues and connect content to your learners. Vyond also offers three different styles of animation. So we have contemporary, whiteboard animation, and business friendly. Now let's take a closer look at what Vyond Studio has to offer. This is the Vyond Studio interface. If you're familiar with other types of video editing software, this will probably look very familiar. In the center here, you have your main stage. This is where you can drag and drop different assets. At the bottom, you have your timeline. This is where you can control when assets come in and come out of your video. So as you can see here, if I click this, you can see all of the entrance animations assigned for each asset. Here, you can expand this to access a huge library of different assets. So you have scenes, props, characters, charts, text, audio, and then your own uploads. And as far as audio goes, you can select this to either add your own recording of a narration, or you can generate text-to-speech. And another popular asset is the character creator. If you don't like any of the characters that they provide, and there are a lot, you can create your own by selecting this. And here you have the option to either copy from your library, generate from photo, or select your own animation style. So those are the main features of Vyond. There are a lot of cool things that we'll do with these different features in the upcoming videos, but we just wanted to give you a general overview so that you can see what the interface looks like if you're not familiar. So now you're probably thinking, sounds great, but what's the cost? Like I mentioned, Vyond is subscription-based, so check out their website for their most recent pricing plans to see if any of them are right for you. They also offer a 2-week free trial option where you can test out a lot of the features that I just talked about. But do keep in mind that every video you download during this free trial will come with a watermark. So we recommend planning ahead. Have some ideas in mind that you can develop before you actually sign up for that trial so you can make the most out of the 2 weeks and see if it's right for you. Your videos do stay in your Vyond cloud. So if you wanted to go back and download it after you've signed up for an account, your videos are there to download without the watermark. If you've looked at the pricing plans and you know that it's just not right for you after those 2 weeks are up, check out our free alternative on how to create quick e-learning animations in PowerPoint for a completely free alternative to using animations in e-learning. But now that we've talked about Vyond and what it is, let's talk about how you can use it in e-learning. The first time I realized I could make a positive impact with Vyond was when I had to create this course on this super complex and honestly pretty boring topic. That's when I had this idea. What if I turned it into a story? So I used Vyond to create these story-driven videos that I weaved throughout my storyline course to help learners better understand that complex topic. What was especially helpful with Vyond specifically was that it let me customize my scenes and my characters to closely match my learner profile and their working environment. It was like bringing the content to life in a way that was completely tailored to them. And it worked really well, actually. We got a lot of positive feedback from learners on how they were better able to grasp the material, but even the subject matter expert that I worked with was completely blown away, wishing they'd thought of something like this years ago. Since then, I've used Vyond in a ton of my e-learning projects, and I want to give you some ideas on how you can use it in yours. So as you can tell from my story, a great way to engage learners with Vyond is by immersing them in storytelling. This is where you can really highlight the character's emotions and actions to make things stick for your learner. You also can use it to simplify complex information. And the high-quality multimedia and visuals that Vyond has to offer are great assets for learner engagement. You can also use it to showcase high-risk scenarios in a risk-free setting, and more on that later. There are also a variety of different use cases for Vyond. The possibilities really are endless, but I want to just give you some ideas for inspiration. So for e-learning projects, you could use it for things like scenarios, storytelling, of course, like we just talked about, weaving it throughout your courses, explainer videos, tutorials, infographics. I've also seen Vyond used in businesses for things like team introductions, internal communications, safety procedures. You could also use it for celebrations, product demonstrations, social media content. And you can also use it for personal branding. So things like visual resumes, visual cover letters, about me videos. You could even use it for a process write-up for a portfolio project if you wanted to. I could see that being really cool. So lots of cool ideas here, and I'm excited to see if anyone tries them out. So now that I've given you a lot of reasons to use Vyond, let's talk about why someone might not want to use Vyond. Now, cost is one thing, so maybe the cost just isn't right for you. Some people just aren't into the animated style either. They prefer the photorealistic look. Sometimes someone wants a more advanced software, something that can do more in terms of animation if you're somebody that's more technical and advanced. And it's also a cloud-based model. So while that might be a positive for a lot of people, some larger companies or corporations may have issues with their information being put into somebody else's cloud. So there could be legal security concerns. There also could be issues with dependency on the provider if there are any crashes or anything like that. So that could also be a reason too that could make it difficult to use Vyond at your company. So definitely consider these things, but I also wanted to provide some realistic information to you on why some people just might not choose to use it. So as I mentioned earlier, a great way to make use of Vyond is to use it to simplify complex or difficult topics. I want to show you how I did this in a recent portfolio project of mine. I created a resource for instructional designers on how to work with subject matter experts to outline learner-centered stories. And throughout development, I anticipated that a particular concept could be confusing, and that was the difference between conflict and obstacles. So I built a video where I had my characters engage in conversation that helped clarify that concept even further. Let's take a look.
Can you clarify the difference between the conflict and obstacles?
Of course. Picture yourself going on a road trip. In a story, the conflict sets the direction towards a specific goal, much like a final destination on your journey. As you progress, obstacles appear as unexpected detours or roadblocks along the way. They're not just barriers, they are essential storytelling elements that add tension and depth.
One of my favorite parts about Vyond is the range of emotions, facial expressions, and character actions that they offer. Really because that's what we can resonate with as humans, and it can make things more memorable if done correctly. Sometimes it's just what you need to make your learner more interested or engaged in your story. In my flagship project, I used the frown emotion and my customer walking away just to show how upset they were with the interaction, and my learner could not only resonate with it, but remember it. Let's watch. So in this course, when the learner makes the incorrect choice, which leads to engaging in pushy sales tactics, this is what happens. So the customer's upset, that's their response. And when you go to continue, it says that you get the customer checked in. And once the customer leaves, this is the review that she writes. Next, I have an example from a flagship project that's still in the works. It's from one of our boot campers, Sally Castle. She's still making the final touches, so the flagship project isn't completely done yet, but it's too impressive not to show you right now. Sally's developing this scenario-based course on how to stay safe from scams. In part of her course, when the learner makes the wrong choice and falls for a scam, Sally strategically shows the negative consequence of their action. Let's check it out.
Why are my cards getting rejected? Why isn't there any money in my account?
I'm sorry, but it appears all your money's been transferred to an offshore account. Have you clicked on a link sent in a text or email recently or given anyone your personal details? If so, you'll need to make a claim with our fraud department.
This work from Sally is such a great example of how you can show rather than just tell your learners. Isn't that much more effective than just telling learners that they can lose all their money by falling for a scam? By playing out the actual consequence, the learners get to simulate what might happen in the real world in a risk-free environment, and they're much more likely to remember it. If you like that style of showing consequences rather than telling, check out our video about making e-learning more memorable. I also want to show you what Sally did for the same scenario, but when the learner actually chose the correct option and didn't fall for the scam. Let's see.
We're aware there's been a scam going around at the moment pretending to be Australia Post. Did you click on the link in the text and enter your personal details?
No, I guess I avoided being scammed then, hey.
Yes, that's for sure. You're scam savvy, not like Dave here. He was supposed to retire last month, but now he has to keep on working because he lost all his super in a scam.
I hope that you found some of those examples inspiring. Really, the examples give you only a small glimpse at what you can do with Vyond. I feel like I'm always finding new things that I can do and new ways to elevate my e-learning when I'm using the software. Vyond's website does offer a lot of helpful resources, and we're also working on some too. In the next video in the series, we'll talk all about the top things you need to know when working with Vyond. So also be sure to leave a comment down below on anything that you want to see in this Vyond series. One thing to keep in mind is that Vyond is not the only animation tool out there, and there are a ton of others that you can explore. But even more importantly, when learning new tools, always remember that it's just a tool. It's not a replacement for good learning and good learning strategies and good learning theory. If you're just starting out with your journey to instructional design, be sure to download the Become an ID checklist down below. Thank you for watching my first video, and I will see you next time.